and Captain Kirk allowed them to beam aboard the station in small groups. When the Enterprise stood down from Red Alert, we all resumed our search for Darvin.
The next band shift in the Enterprise scan cycle will be in 3 minutes.
We'll be ready, Major. O'Brien out.
We should find a turbolift.
Hello again.
Hello.
Deck 10.
Your flap's open.
Excuse me?
On your tricorder, you're draining power.
Oh.
Thank you.
He's always doing that.
You're a doctor?
Yes.
I just transferred here from the Lexington last week.
Welcome aboard.
I'm coming into sick bay tomorrow for my physical. $1,500. Lieutenant Watley.
You realize, of course, she was just using you to get to me.
Watley? That was my great-grandmother's name.
Funny.
And I think she was in Starfleet.
Well, that's a common enough name.
But what if that was her?
Oh, do you realize the odds?
No one ever met my great-grandfather. This could be a predestination paradox. Come on, Chief, surely you took elementary temporal mechanics at the Academy. I could be destined to fall in love with that woman and become my own great-grandfather.
You're being ridiculous.
Ridiculous? If I don't meet with her tomorrow, I may never be born.
Chief, are you ready for transport?
Are we ever?
Stand by.
You saw the way she looked at me. You can't just dismiss this.
I can try.
All right. Fine. But I can't wait to get back to Deep Space Nine and see your face when you find out that I never existed.